All right. That's what we got. That's what we're going to get. We're going to go here. We're going to try this. All right. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Good morning. Welcome in. Welcome in. Everybody welcome. Everybody welcome. Well, I guess everybody would be welcome. How y'all doing this morning, right? Good stuff. Good stuff. Good stuff. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. I pray that everybody is well. Come on. Good morning. Welcome in to the Everyday Until Dynamic Devotion and Prayer. This is your 8 a.m. experience. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good morning. Come on. Welcome. Come on, Saturday. Come on, Saturday. All right, all right, all right. Yep. Yep. Well, if I could type, it'd be better. Well, I can type. I'll type better than what I type now. It's just big fingers, y'all. And sensitive keyboards. All right, all right. Good morning, good morning. Callers, good morning, Facebook, good morning, YouTube, IG. Good morning, everybody. Y'all know, come on in with your worship. Come on in with your praise. Come on in this morning, your city and your state that you're watching or you're calling from. Welcome in. I'm glad you're here. If this is your first time, thank you so much for joining us. If you have a prayer request, please place it in the comment section. We call that the wall. And whether you're doing it on IG or on Facebook, YouTube, we're going to comb through it and find your prayer and pray with you. If you feel like your prayer is a little bit more private in nature, please click on the link there and or go to our website, amazingchurch.com. Click on the Connect tab. And then the prayer form will show up then. Within 48 hours, we will have prayed for your prayer. And if your prayer requires faith-filled instructions, we will communicate with you. So fill it out in its entirety, all right? Come on, y'all. Good morning. Let's go. Yeah, yeah. Glad that y'all are here this morning. Got something for you. Come on, can we thank God for our team? Man, my team is always ready. And there are things that are happening that we're excited about. I'm excited about things with y'all. Come on, Digital City, that's what we're in. Come on, our own tribe, our digital tribe. Let's go. That's what I'm going to call my tribe, Digital City. All right, so remember, we believe for ambassadors on the 27th, that Saturday, 10 a.m., we won't hold you to more than about 30 minutes. If you want to be an ambassador, represent your state, your city, your region, your area, you want to partner with others, you want to be the name that we call when someone asks, do you have somebody in this area that can pray? I want you to know that it is our intercession that's holding things together, and we need every one of you. So if you want to be an ambassador to hold it down, make sure that you register. Go to our website there. We need to make sure that that's right. I think it's got the wrong date on it. Right form, just wrong date on the graphic. We need to go there and make sure that you register so that we'll have your name and prepared for you. All right. Also, those of you that are at Amazing Church, you're partnering with us globally and or you are a member with us locally. Come on, y'all ready for it? We're having our Mission Possible. That's our church-wide vision day. That's where everybody in our church is invited to come out. We've partnered with one of the local churches that can hold us so that we can socially distance, but also hold all of us. Make sure that you are registered for that, because we're taking care of your lunch on that day. It is an advance. It is not a retreat. I said that accidentally. It is an advance. So make sure that you register. We want everybody to be a partner. Everybody to be the partner actually with us. And show on March the 20th. It's March the 20th at 10 a.m. All of the details are there. Make sure that you go and get that information. And then finally, celebrating on the week just before that, or that same week, celebrating, we will have done EDU Every Day Until Dynamic Devotion and Prayer for a year. Somebody, come on, give God praise for it on this Saturday morning. Let's go. Come on, let's get it. I know you're right. I know you're right. I know you're right. All right. So those are the things that are happening. We're glad that that you guys get to be a part of that and thankful. All right. All right. So every day we give you inspiration, and that inspiration comes out of the Word of God. That's why it's called inspiration. Then we give you motivation. What is that word saying? And the inspiration and motivation we have, but the application you have. So without further ado, let's go ahead and take a look at your inspiration this morning. Come on, somebody said ready already. Did you say ready already? Regardless of where you are. Come on, come on. I'm telling you, that's it. Luke, the ninth chapter. Luke, the ninth chapter. Last verse, verse 62. Luke, the ninth chapter, verse 62. Now, I got to be honest with you, because come on, I'm going to be real transparent with you. I had Philippians, the third chapter, verse 13. But I count not myself to be apprehended. That was a powerful statement. But as I was looking at it, studying it for a minute, I hit this verse, and I think that this verse is applicable for this morning, especially for myself, and I think for the rest of us, to make sure that we stay honest with ourselves. This is what it says, and when I read it, you'll understand. It says, "But Jesus said to him," now Jesus said to him, read it, Derek. "But Jesus said to him, no one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. No one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God." Y'all, that is like, wow. It is a familiar passage. It is a powerful passage. But there's something in here that I think is a principle, as Pastor Tanya said, a timeless principle. This is a principle coming out of here that I think is timeless for you. This is something that you will definitely, absolutely go, wow. You ready for it? All right. So, but Jesus said to him, now this is Jesus making reference to a parabolic type delivery of what I'm about to say. He's telling him, you know, hey, listen, all of this stuff, you want to come follow me? You want to be a disciple? Being a disciple is different than just being a believer. Yeah, see, being a believer has something to do with you acknowledging and believing that Jesus Christ is Lord, that he is the Son of God, that he died, believing the gospel. That's a believer of the way. But being a disciple is obeying what the way is, obeying the way, following it. Living that and making disciples, or another person will be discipled as a result of you. See, that's the focus. When you're a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ, you're a disciple of the kingdom of God, you're a disciple, you are living in such a way that others are going to pattern their lives behind you, pattern their walk with God behind what you do. There's something that you do that illuminates to them that this, there's a value associated with the decision that you made to follow Christ. So Jesus is saying to him, you want to follow me? You want to be a disciple of mine? Really? Hey, listen, you can't be looking. No one having put his plow, no one having decided to go forward, no one having decided to destroy hard ground to get it prepared to receive seed. See, most think that putting the hand to the plow was the actual sowing of the seed. No, that's just the breaking up of the ground so that the seed will have an opportunity to get in. So no one having put his hand to the plow, no one deciding to be a follower of Jesus, a disciple of Jesus, no one deciding to be a trendsetter, to go first, to go forward, no one deciding to create a path and leave a trail for others to follow. Nobody doing that. No one's going to decide to do that. Jesus is saying, if you're going to follow me, if you want to follow me, you don't have time to go back and no, this is a forward step in. And once you step in, man, listen, you're forsaking everything else to follow. This is what you're doing. This is what you have decided to do. I've decided to follow Jesus. Jesus said, if no one haven't put his hand to the plow, you have to put your hand to the plow. Now, many have taught you that you have to look forward so that you can keep straight lines so that that could be the case. Well, we already know that a believer, if a righteous man sins seven times, you're not going to keep a straight line. So this necessarily is, that's a great idea. That is a great, great idea. Trust me. However, this is not saying that. This is actually saying, it says you have to be focused forward. And this looking back is, you've got to be careful of regretting the soil that you have turned over. Regretting the soil that you have separated, you have broken apart. You've got to be careful regretting the soil that you have turned over. See, you're finding yourself that you appreciate the hard soil without the seed more than you're going to appreciate the separating. You can't regret who you are now and always have this reference, man, you better be glad I'm saved. No, you glad you saved. Stop saying somebody else better be glad, because that is referencing the previous you and giving more value to the previous you than the present you. So when you make that announcement, you're not saying something positive. You're actually giving more credence to who you used to be, which is somebody that raised a lot of hell. It's basically what you're saying. You're saying that, listen, if I was who I used to be, I'd really get you. No, I thank God that I'm not who I used to be. Not I thank God I'm not who I used to be or I would get you. I thank God I'm not who I used to be. You don't need to make that announcement. You don't need to make that announcement. You need to be focusing and understanding that. Don't look back. Don't go referencing old parties and how y'all had a good time. Not referencing it in terms of you can't remember it. Not referencing it when you're not looking at it based on where God has brought you. I'm not saying that because, boy, look here. You remember this? I remember when, I thank God that he brought me. That's different than what I'm saying. There are a lot of people, believers, that are relishing in your previous moments as if that was a better life. as if that was a better life. You forgot the reason why you got saved. You got saved because the life that you was living, you was either tired, you was in trouble, or you was broken. You got to a place. I know me personally. I just retired. I don't want to live like this no more. I'm done. I'm out of here. This ain't profiting me like I want it to. It's not. You can have everything in the world, but if you lose your soul, what profit did you have? You had fun. Hey, the pleasure of seeing lasts for a season. But when you try to prolong the season, listen, it's summer. You still trying to make it winter. You walk around with a coat on, but it's 150 degrees. You are valuing a previous moment greater than the present moment that you're in. If you got that, somebody give God praise for it. Come on, give him glory for it. That's what it's saying. That's what it's saying, all right? And then it says, it's fit for the kingdom. This is what Jesus said. Anyone who is valuing your previous life more than the present one, you can't go with me. You can't run. Jesus said, you can't hang. You can't be with me. You can't. That's what he said. He said, you can't go with me because you're going to slow us down. How you gonna slow us down? Because you keep looking back at what you preach. You need to go back to that. Since that was so good, you need to go back to that. Since that was so great for you, you need to go back to that. Since you listen, that's why I tell people all the time. If you keep looking at your past, preventing you from seeing the prophesied future of your purpose and destiny, you'll always have it infiltrated. You'll never get there because you're slow. I say people are trying to go forward, but you got the wheels down on the airplane and it's creating a drag. You're getting there, but it's a struggle. You're burning more fuel than necessary. I'm telling you, I'm gonna say it. What hurt you in the past is in the past. Yeah. What is it going to take to get you to understand that you have had trauma? Yes. And you have hurt? Yes. But man, you can't live there. Yes, you were strong back then. You was bad. Nobody messed with you. I understand. But getting older is beautiful, not terrible. Come on, y'all. Jesus say, if you want your past life, go live that. You obviously can't run with me. You can't run with me. I want to run with the Lord. Anybody else besides me want to run with the Lord? Understand what I'm saying, all right? He says, but Jesus said to him, no one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit. You ain't even able. You're not physically able. You're not spiritually fit. You're not emotionally fit to go forward. So you have to stay in this hole. You have to stay here because you cannot do it. You do not possess the capacity to move forward because you value your pain more than your future. You value what happened and you're going, I don't value that. I actually hate that. Well, no, you actually value it because you refuse to move forward. And then your refusal to move forward is an indication that you give value to what had done already been happened. All right, so what's your motivation? I'm messing with some of y'all this morning. I want y'all to come back tomorrow, 8 a.m. Come on back tomorrow, all right? Here you go. All right, here's your motivation. Jesus says that you cannot be all in, come on, you cannot be all in regretting a past you value more than your future. That's why there are plans that I have for you. That's what I want. Listen, come on. That's it. This is going to help you with your motivation today. I feel God in this. I sense the presence of God. I've got the gooseies. I'm going to read it to you again. Come on. Somebody said, come on, Pastor. Yeah, I got to get it to you again. Jesus says that you cannot be all in regretting a past you value more than your future. You cannot be all in. You cannot give yourself fully to your husband regretting the pain of your boyfriend. You cannot. You cannot be a great parent always looking back at how bad your parents were to you. You cannot. You cannot be a great employee in a new company and looking for a new position when you're still upset about what happened in the previous one. You done made an inner vow and commitment. This ain't gonna ever happen to me, not realizing that inner vow and commitment just became a scripture that's prophesying your life. About what you won't do, about what won't happen to you, about listen, are y'all hearing me? He said, you're not even fit. Why? Because we can't run with you. You hurt, you limping, you weak. Your walk is gonna be weak. Every time God try to tell you something, you're gonna reference your pain first before you go with what God has said. Are you getting what I'm trying to tell you? It will prevent you from being able to move forward. Whatever it is, I'm gonna give you your application. I'm gonna read this to you one more time. Here's your motivation. One more time. Jesus says that you cannot be all in regretting a past you value more than your future. That's why there are plans I have for you. Jesus says, now you're going all back there talking about you got to take care of this, you got to take care of that before you can go forward. That's the truth. You do, because that's who you are. You can't go forward. You got to go take care of all of that before you come and walk with me. Jesus didn't say, I'll wait for you. He says, you ain't fit. Wow! You would have thought that Jesus, God wants everybody to be saved. Here it is. They're giving him the reasons why they can't go forward. And Jesus doesn't. It is not a healing. He ain't prophesied to them. He ain't tell them, listen, I understand. He said this to them, you not even fit. Are y'all reading this Bible? Am I getting too hype? I'm telling you, I hope y'all hear me. I hope you hear me very clearly. Jesus did not go. He deal with it. He just said, okay, you ain't ready. I wish he would have said, you're not ready. He actually said, you're not fit. My goodness. Wow, y'all. So your app today. Somebody say today. Somebody say today. My goodness. Somebody say today. You can't be all in regretting the past. You can't be all in focusing on what happened. Jesus is trying to get you somewhere. He says, for I know the plans I have for you. The plans God has a plan for you. You think the plan that God has for you to keep refreshing, putting a refresh button on things that happened previously? Let's go. Today. All right. Today. Write something down. Write down something you know you haven't done because of something you have done or has been done to you in the past. Write down something you know you haven't done because of something that you have done or something that was done to you in your past. Then move forward. Write it down. Then move forward. All right? Write it down. Write it down. Why gotta write it down? Write it down. Writing is therapy. Okay. If you say it, your words don't have as much value as you think they do because you're talking about how much you trust the Lord, but you're still fearful. So I need to give your words some value. What you need to do is write it down first. Come on, write it down first. Ooh, I'm afraid to buy a house because the last house I bought. I don't want that kind of car no more because of the last time I had one of them cars. Shoot, all men are dogs because the last one I had dogged me. Y'all know I mess with y'all. I ain't never going to that restaurant no more. Last time I went there, shoot, that fool had a piece of hair in it. See, all of that stuff is coaching you up so that you don't move forward. All of that is just coaching. You don't know how to get the restaurant to go, hey, man, listen, it's got some hair in it. Okay, good, no problem. Come back. I like my restaurant. I ain't stopped going to my restaurant because of a piece of hair. You know how many pieces of hair have been in your food at home? You ain't stopped going home. I'm telling y'all, I ain't buying that kind of car. Shoot, you, the new car you got the same tires that the other car had on. Yeah, some stuff really doesn't make sense. When you think about ego, it really doesn't make sense. You just got programmed. You got programmed by your environment to give value to past pain over the promises of God, the promises of your future. If you're led and guided by the Holy Spirit, then that means that whatever mistake that you have made, God is going to lead you in a place where you can find repentance. And that repentance is in your heart. Have I helped y'all this morning? If I helped you this morning, send up the hearts. Come on, let's give God praise for it this morning before we get ready to pray. Come on. Y'all, no, it's Saturday. Y'all know it's Saturday. What are we going to do on Saturday? On Saturday, we do it together. Let's go. Let's start adoring him. Let's adore him. Let's acknowledge him. Come on. Let's give him praise and glory this morning. This information that you got this morning is blessing you. How do you know it's blessing me? Because the word of God is alive, and that should have helped somebody. You are able to move forward in spite of what previously happened. And you're able to move forward actually in some of the places where the pain was present. You can keep going forward, y'all. Because you're part of the kingdom of God, not the kingdom of the earth. You're not stuck here. Paul says, I do not count myself to be apprehended, arrested, stopped, halted in this moment. I press, he says, I push further in towards the upward calling, not just press in, upward calling, high calling. It's greater than the earth. I have to go above. Even though I know trauma is real and it happened and it lodges in, we have to be willing or to realize I need some help because I have a viewpoint that is not kingdom. When my viewpoint is not kingdom, which is the reason why you need to know the word of God, because it is the word that makes one free. It is the knowledge of this word that makes you free. If you don't know this word, it won't make you, oh my goodness, it won't make you free. You'll be stuck and bound to false truths. You'll be stuck and bound to hearing things that tantalize your ear and or get in agreement with your emotions. You'll get stuck with getting in agreement with your emotions. And so that's why people are so highly proliferated when they make a social media post that is so negative, and people celebrate it because they're feeling that emotional negativity, when really it has nothing to do with God, and it has something to do with the I guess the word could be properly appropriated, the aggrandizement of their pain, their trauma. Man, y'all be careful celebrating your trauma. Let's acknowledge Father. Let's adore Him. Father, we bless You. Father, we glorify You. We know that You're a great God. You're a great King. Come on, let's do it together, y'all. Come on. Hallelujah. Write it in your comments. Father, we bless You. You're the great old God that we love. You're the great almighty God, and we love You. You're the grand Father. You're the awesome God. You're the ancient one. There is none before You. There was none that created. There's no one that has the power that You have. God, You speak the stars and the sky, the moon, the earth. You spoke it, God, and it obeyed You. There are things that were not present that became present because Your thoughts had already created them, and they became what You said they would be. And so, God, we magnify You. We glorify You. We thank You, Father, for this morning. We thank You for waking us up. We thank You for Your word. Your word is clear. We honor You on this morning, God. We bless Your holy name. Father, in this moment, we ask, come on, let's confess. Let's confess our sins and ask for forgiveness. Father, this morning, we ask that You forgive us for all of our sins, the areas where we missed the mark, the moments, God, where we have slipped, times, God, where we have come against the kingdom when we're supposed to be supporting and for the kingdom. Help us, God, and things that we don't even remember that we may have done and missed the mark, things that we know that we did, God, we repent, we change our mind about it, God, we ask for assistance and help. God, we ask because Your words for us to come to You. Yes, Lord God, we go to each other confessing our faults so that we may be healed, but we come to You, God, confessing our sins so that we may be forgiven. We need Your forgiveness, God. We want You to come, God. Cleanse us and wash us according to God. Purge us and make us new. God, see if there's any wicked thing in us. We want to be right before You. Oh, God, oh, wonderful Savior. You are the blessed God in whom we love. And we know, God, that we cry out to You. You hear us. But, God, You hear us, answer us, show us great and mighty things. And, God, we are believing for miracles, signs, and wonders to follow us. And because we believe, God, we speak, and what we speak is out of our hearts. So in the abundance of our heart, our mouth is reflective of what it is that we believe. And we believe that You are God. We believe that You are the great I am. We believe, Father God, that You hear us. And we believe, God, that You're changing and transforming us in every moment, in every way. Come on. Now we move to the Thanksgiving part. And with that, as a result of what God has done, we're grateful. Let's give Him thanks. Come on. Bless His name. That's your hallelujahs. That's, oh God, I glorify You. That's You knowing that God did something so great for you that you can't even explain it. You understand that this forgiveness just on the day, this forgiveness just on the day that God gave you the breath in your body that you're able to confess and go to Him, that you did not have to be put along the side. Come on, somebody, give Him praise. Give Him glory. Wake up the folk in your house today. Turn your music all the way up for a hot second. Come on. Come on. Hallelujah. Bless Your name. Thank You, Lord, for forgiving me. If you're glad He forgave you, if you're glad about it, come, glory to God. I thank You, Lord, for Your forgiveness. I thank You, God. The little small thing that could have held me up, the little thing that could have hindered my blessing from coming forth, the thing, God, that could have slowed us down so much that, God, looking back at the past, whoo, Father, thank You for Your forgiveness. Thank You, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank You, Lord. Thank you. Give him praise for it. Your word says you inhabit the praises of the people. Your word says that God, you, Father God, will place your glory on man, but your glory is on for those that walk uprightly before you. You said that there's no good thing that you shall withhold from those of us that walk uprightly before you. You says, God, you said it in your word that we are of the just, and the just shall live by faith. And our faith comes from God, knowing and hearing you. And so we exercise our faith this morning by giving you praise, declaring that you will inhabit our praises, declaring that your presence will show up as a result of. And God, we love you. And because of your loving kindness towards us, the least we can do is offer ourselves as living sacrifices. And so we worship you. We declare, God, that your kindness towards us, your loving and benevolent kindness towards us, deserves, God, our worship. Oh, we love you. Oh, we bless your name. Oh, God. If we were even together in this moment now, God, we would give a sound, God. There is a greater sound when we are together. And therefore, God, here in our digital tribe this morning, we're going to send up the hearts. In our tribe this morning, we're going to send up the praise. We bless your name this morning. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody give him glory. Come back here. Focus on me. Don't worry about Bishop. Glory to God. Glory to God. And let's take on what we've been doing. Let's take on what we've been doing. Now it's the time to ask, make your petition known, supplication. Father, we ask today, we ask that you would heal those that are in need of healing now. God, your word declares that one can chase 1,000, but two of us together can put 10,000 to flight. And so God, we declare in Jesus' name that all of our collective faith together, it's more than one or two of us here, God. We declare it. That God, things will change because we are in the earth and we're proclaiming your name and declaring your word to go forward. Your word says that it will not return void. It will do the thing that it was sent to do. And you said that we shall lay hands upon the sick. You said we shall speak those things that be not as though they were. You said, we're telling you what you said. And so God, we have an expectation that you're going to heal those that are sick. We send your word now to places where sickness and disease in the physical body is racking God and hindering. God, all the way to Georgia, we are sending prayer. God, all the way to East Texas, we're sending the word of God for healing. All the way to Florida, Baltimore, Washington, D.C., Minnesota, God, Washington State. God, right here in McKinney, Texas, we could call out the names of those that are in need of healing. Physically in their body, we ask that you heal them. Those, Father God, that are dealing with death, knocking at the door. God, if it is not their time, we ask that you would extend them as you did with Hezekiah. That you would extend them, Father God, to fulfill your word. Your word says that their latter days shall be greater than their former. God, your word says to them that you will satisfy them with a long life. God, somebody may not be satisfied. So God, in Jesus' name, we ask that you just perform your word. It says, God, that you are faithful to perform it, that you're not slack concerning your promise. And all of your promises are yes and amen, and so we receive them all. God, in Jesus' name, we intercede now on behalf of the foolish ones, those that are caught by the spirit of stupor, those that are caught in the web of Satan, those that are caught in the web of youth. Your word says that foolishness is bound in the heart of the child. Those that are caught in immaturity, we ask God that you deliver them now, that you break them free from those thought patterns, and that you would remember them to the kingdom thoughts and heal them now in the name of the Lord Jesus, even if they're present in this call and on this call, God, that you would heal the mind from the trauma, the pain, God. And God, however it happens to happen or has to happen, make it available for them. Give them an epiphanic moment. God, open up their eyes. Give them the epiphany that they need to talk to someone to release what has happened in the past. And give those that they talk to the words to speak. Your word says that we shall have no worry for words, for in that hour you shall give us what to speak. So God, I declare in Jesus' name, hallelujah, that people are delivered from foolishness, delivered from foolish talk and foolish thought, that they would use their faith to quench the fiery darts of the enemy. And we have your word on it. Your word says that you will not leave us, God, ignorant to the devil's devices. So God, give them an enlightenment. Open up their eyes and hearts to see and to hear. God, stubbornness, I hear it now. The spirit of stubbornness that's preventing people from moving forward because they feel that there is some weakness in moving forward past some pains that were brought upon them and causing them to have arrogance and pride in stupidity. God, in Jesus' name, your word says that if for those that refuse correction is stupid. God, help them now. Let our humility be example before them. For your word says that you exalt the humble, God, but you resist the proud, in Jesus' name. So, God, while we're here, while we're before your throne, if there's any way in us, God, that we're being stubborn and stupid and refuse, God, to refuse being foolish, help us. Show us so that we can bring your glory, so that someone will be able to see our lives and decide to pattern their walk thereby. God, we need you. Woo! We need you ourselves this morning. We need heal us in the name of the Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, that your word will go to hospitals and places where the sick are. God, we come against the coronavirus, COVID-19. We bind it now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We declare that you're not only flattening the curve and healing people through vaccinations, through miracles, the laying on of hands, and these words that we're sending. God, that no one will be infected. No one will die as a result of it. You're saying that it's happening. No, we are praying. We're interceding now. While the battle is happening, we're interceding now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for being our great Lord. We love you. We praise you. We give you thanks. We declare that we believe that we receive what we pray now in this present moment with persecutions, with the drama that comes along with it. We magnify. In Jesus' name, hallelujah, amen. Come on, somebody, give God praise for it this morning. Come on, give him glory for it this morning. Give him glory for it this morning. Come on, like, comment, share, and tag. That's what we say. That's what it's been this morning. Thank y'all for joining. My goodness. My goodness. Absolutely adore you. Absolutely adore you. I pray you got something out of that this morning. Listen, this has been the Everyday Until 8 a.m. Experience. I'm Derek Golden. Thank you so much for joining with us. And if the Lord shall say the same, meet us back here tomorrow morning at the same time, 8 a.m. Central Standard Time, that is. And we will continue with our dynamic devotion and prayer. I love you. Have a great day. Thank y'all, callers. Be blessed. All right, IG. Appreciate y'all. Have a wonderful day. Facebook IG, thank y'all. All right, have a great day. We'll see y'all in a little bit. Be blessed.